And we are live. Hello, everybody. You read the title. Sorry, no stream on the SMP. I'm actually going to change the name later on. Because, sorry if I sound like I'm eating, but it's because I am. I'm eating pizza again. Oh, butter. And today, what I have in plan is the tutorial on how to build the shay. The shay. But for right now, I'm just eating. I'm gonna wait for Cube. Chocolate chip cookies! No, chocolate filled. Damn. There's a link, my brother. My brother boy, Johnny John Johnson. Don't y'all just love the Little Caesars cheese and jalapeno salsa? I love it. Jalapenos, the cheese and jalapeno salsa. I love that shit. That shit is awesome. Carl Johnson, question mark. Bro, they say Brazil is all bad and shit. I'm going to get copyrighted, but I don't give a crap. They say Brazil is all in shit or whatever, but then you just envision this. Welcome to Brazil, my friend. We have beautiful women, beautiful landscapes, and a lot of mafia. How are you, Q? I presume not good. I think he's speaking Morse code. God, we're right. Dumb shits.
Also, look at my, here, give me a second. Look at my beautiful name.
Dream knockoff. Yes.
Yeah, see, it's funny. Also, you say you're going to build shay. I'm excited to see that because I'm working on logging Juju.
I was going to say, it's funny because both of them are crudely drawn in MS Paint, and one of them is always in streams and the other one never uploads. I haven't seen a video of Dream in a long time.
You never see me and Dream in the same room. Have you ever realized that?
Oh, Dream is texting, confirm he did.
Oh my god, it's Dream? I am never going to say that. That was the most cringy shit that has come out of my mouth.
Bro, okay, so, do you like to play GTA 5?
I would like to, but I can't, because I ain't got the game.
Okay, hear me out. a Brazilian version of GTA.
Okay.
Hear me out. So it's like the trailer rolls up. I don't know what the game is called, but yet. But it's like, so this is our new place. Welcome.
GTA 6 confirmed.
No, hold on. It's welcome to our new place, family. This is where we're going to be living. Welcome to Brazil, my friend. With the city of the capital. No, wait. Fuck, I messed it up. It's sorry. It's So this is where we're going to be living now. Welcome to Brazil, my friend. Sao Paulo, the city of wonder. I hope you. You said how much you needed to, again to go to back to America. No, wait, I fucked it up again.
Wait, real quick. I have a funny joke, real quick, before you say that. I actually have exactly what Casey Jones said right as he crashed into the back of that train.
What?
Ready?
Oh my god! God damn it!
Just. I'm fucking stupid.
Bro, okay, so here's the trailer, now that I've thought about it. It's, so this is where we're going to be living now, huh? Welcome to Brazil, my friend. Sao Paulo, the city of wonder. Come right in. And it just pans out to the beautiful scenery of Brazil. The beautiful Amazon and rainforest and a bunch of the city and the iconic parts.
And then a fucking cockroach.
No, hold on. And it's just like showing everything. The NPCs and shit. So how much money did you say you needed again go to America? I needed $17,000. Do you know any way I could earn money? I might know something. What is that? Here in Brazil, there's plenty of mafia. Is it not illegal? Yes. But the government allows it as long as you pay them. And it just shows you fight, shows the main. Wait. And it's just like, is it not illegal? Yes. If you pay the government, it's not. And it just shows you fighting every single enemy on the game, enemy mafias and shit like that. When that part kicks in. Of course, I have to edit it better than instead of just clicking.
I'm just fucking vibing.
Bro, but basically, this game is kind of Sleeping Dogs, but GTA 5 and GTA 5 combined, and if it was located in Brazil. That's my idea.
Sounds part like of a sleeping... pretty hot idea, little Billy.
Now, go back to making us food. Aw.
Imagine that's the ending. It's like, yeah, stop with your dreams. Go back to make food for the family. And then that's how the trailer is, GTA fucking Brazil edition.
I know.
It seems like a pretty good concept, though.
Yeah. Well, I thought about it, like, wait a minute, that doesn't sound so bad.
GTA 6 confirmed?
Wait, wasn't that supposed to be in Colombia? Strange.
Screams in southern.
Now it's time to come. Now it's time. This is where I got also my kind of my idea. Look. And when that part, like, when it says, like, welcome to Brazil, my friend. No, wait. So this is not where we are going to be living, huh? Yep. This is our new home. And it just shows a stereotypical white American in Brazil who has a Brazilian accent because he has been living there for a long time. You know, I don't know. And it's just like, welcome to Sao Paulo, my friend. The city of wonder. This is perfectly, basically it. Doesn't that actually kind of fit in?
Yeah, it does.
Yeah. No, I just need $17,000 to go back to America and go to Rockstar and tell them I have a game idea. If you would like to hear.
You're gonna tell them that, and they'll say GTA 6 is already coming out next year, and it's like it's not coming. So it's never coming out. Yeah. Okay.
Oh. Christ in Tubo. But yeah, basically that song is just. I had that idea. Also, I need to show you a video from the Discord. You could see it in the Discord if you had that. So get Discord.
What the fuck is this? Schaefer, what the fuck do you watch in your spirit?
No more babies.
No more babies. What the fuck?
It's like the many XD videos that I have, like the two ones that I have.
Oh my god, for fuck's sake! The SpongeBob music is what makes it better.
I know.
As he's absolutely getting fucking cock and ball tortured.
I know. Also, I need this. I was going to show you, like, imagine, like, I don't know. I don't know, we die and we're, I don't know, fucking hell or something. I don't know where we're going to be going. And like, what did you die of? Oh, I got in a car crash. And you train? I was run over by
what
a train.
What's the end goal here?
Hey, bro, it worked. We died.
Everyone in hell realizing that I'm that guy who likes a lot of trains. Epic death, bro. That didn't make much sense, right? But...
And it's like... God damn it,
okay, so we all shit in the shower.
Yeah. Who doesn't do that?
Me after finding out I'm. Everybody
hurts. I love it.
This telling me they lost respect for me because I made some joke about something. How do they expect me to react?
Oh, what am I going to do without underscore XX Isaiah WXX underscores respect? I just can't even...
When I...
So, really, there's this filter that's supposed to show you how your crush sees you.
Oh, my...
Ha ha. cries in Mexican.
Bro,
cries
I
in
like a fucking
music.
Chair. I know.
Cries in.
cries in La Chona.
Cries in La Chona.
Bro, it's just this guy. Oh my god. Also.
Everybody hurts.
No, yeah. Who doesn't do that?
Who doesn't do that? Everybody
hurts. Me realizing that I'm the only person in this world who has the Niagara.
Who doesn't do that? Everybody
hurts. Why am I upset? It's not that I'm the only one. There needs to be more Niagara. Don't you agree, Q? Excellent. Moving on. This has been my TED Talk. Oh, yeah! I need
when
to show
you...
you
to your first glass skywalk, but then... Everyone starts jumping to see if the glass will break, or if we will all fall 900...
Let me see if I can find it. Let me see if I can find the YouTuber. I doubt I'm going to find it. What if I just find search
Everybody hurts.
Let's see if I can find the guy.
I love how he's just like, shut up, and the water just dropped. Just face. I don't know why that's so funny.
I know. Oh yeah, what was this?
Did my camera actually turn on as it fell and plummeted to on the fucking floor?
I don't know. Good question. Bill Words? Now I search Bill Words music. Music.
Yeah, I'll be right back. Give me a second.
And there he is. Chris Charles Cornell. Okay, I'm back.
Among Us.
Cube, look. This is literally what? You.
That one kid in the class.
Oh, god.
You know the kid I'm talking about, the one that for some reason chokes on everything.
Uh-huh. Ah, this one.
That was an F.
Oh, okay.
I am looking for a part.
It's like somewhere in there. That's a horrible sound. Never make that sound again, Charles. Let's not do that. It's closer to perfect. We can make this sound like a carnival.
Heat. Burn this thing. Burn this thing. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Satan, you bow your knee. Satan, you bow your knee. You fall on your face.
You fall on your face.
COVID-19.
That was an F. That was literally the dumbest thing ever.
Why does that actually fit? Like an old timey whiny days. Oh, that's spicy.
Oh, fun fact.
That's spicy.
Boxcar Willie's version of the Wabash Cannonball is bussin'.
I know.
Him, I know what, Johnny Cash's, is his is pretty good, but then... Wait, what? What the fuck? What, okay.
This, not him, what this? Is the incurable...
That's bitching. I forgot his name. The rest of it. There's a guy who's crapped all the steam in bread.
Phobia of trains.
Wanting to build tramways in...
their balls. People in from miles around.
A bridge over nothing.
I don't like it for two reasons.
And this caused some confusion.
Excuse me. Do you mind if I... terribly sorry. Excuse me, could I just get...
This day, it's only used by wankers.
Hello, I'm Sir Edmund Halloween.
F*** you, Mrs. Panhandle. It's of half a penny.
Nature reserve I'm currently trespassing on.
What? I propose that we open the airport.
It's armadillos!
Hamstrung.
Armadillos! Why is that funny?
Texas be like, armadillo!
Right.
You see, it's funny because the South has a large amount of armadillo.
Didn't you have a city called Armadillo?
No, it's the animal. Armadillos.
Huh.
Ham sandwich and ham sweet ham. Out giving everyone an orgasm.
You better not forget the name Chelsea when you name on your
birth.
I'm gonna come around here and I'm gonna feel.
When he says I'm gonna give everyone an orgasm, that's you when you built the Niagara. I'm gonna give.
No, it says
hamstrung, ham sandwich, and ham sweet ham.
Out giving everyone an orgasm.
It just sounds like I'm giving everyone an orgasm.
Sandwich and ham sweet ham.
It says without giving everybody an orgasm. I watched this guy. me saying I'm going to scrap the Niagara everyone without giving them an orgasm. I did not scrap it. Just say, I was going to, at one point.
You better not forget the name Chelsea when you name our new borough, or I'm gonna come around here and I'm gonna feel, or I'm gonna wash this in the forest.
Just its borders.
Sorry.
Hey, I'm the only one that should be dying of coughing here, not you.
I saw that wrong.
Obsessed with vacuum cleaners. 9 foot deep in horse manure by 1950.
Really? Surely no one cares about this place.
Which is now a nothing.
I hate myself.
World War, round two.
Proper borough.
Maybe it's because we Brits have always been overly attached to our cars.
No moment, though.
Okay.
Some porn stars. Problem of congestion in London. And successfully kept the entire central.
You heard that?
That's the mood. Yep.
Press
that's mood. In the mood.
You can afford the new car.
Seven. Kent.
Huh? Oh.
No. Although very the trolley bus.
You don't want your house knocked down, do you?
No.
This nice street was on their hit list.
Britain.
Stevenage. Allegiance to Surrey. In fact, they could go literally anywhere.
So they like it or not. They should never have built this stupid house.
A house big enough for your mum?
Really? Much more convenient than this boat.
1886.
A much more convenient thing than this boat. That's one hell of a line.
Boat.
That's an insanely accurate sound effect.
Which one?
You do gotta admit. This one, listen.
56, Thatcher had.
Hounslow means Hounslow! Death to Ealing!
Okay.
Death to Hillingdon!
Yeah! Look at me! Out of my way! I'm the... I'm the North Circular! Hey!
Oi! Pay your council tax!
Why don't you come over here and make me?
Had enough, and she had the GLC abolished.
I can't feel my legs!
I will not be deterred!
With a leaf, text with website underneath, fox's head with eagle's palms, lots of boring coats of arms, flower, tree, stolen from the BBC, very...
Stolen from the BBC, ain't that ironic?
90s, round and bold, painted by a 5-year-old. Flappy triangles appeal, happy crown and water wheel. Circle skyline, painty, lame, looks like someone signed their name. Swirly B and swishy N, boring coats of arms again. 8 blobs, no one understands.
All you needed was loads of money.
Massive lawn with...
That is... that actually sounds good, doesn't it?
No.
Oh! My pizza crust.
Your what?
Pizza.
With an angry guy telling you to get off my land!
Empty. Straight in front of a tram. Abercrombie was dead by now.
Anyway.
Wow.
So how are you again, my dear?
I'm dead. Oh!
Don't you just like that it's already Friday and it's in the afternoon?
Yeah.
Which means Wakan.
I'm right now building a log car because I saw this actually nice documentary about a logging railroad that's still here. That's nice.
Damn. So you're the welcome to the gang. And also I'm not doing the thing yet. Because I'm still eating pizza. And I'm already all full.
Yo, can I have some?
What? Yeah.
Thanks, man.
That's the good version, you do gotta admit.
Yeah.
Let's face it, who doesn't break down to Union Dixie?
I do, I break down to it. You sound like that one pufferfish meme. You know the one where they basically just feed the pufferfish like a carrot and just
I know which one it is. I know which one it is. I'll be right back.
Once was a lad that put to sea. The name was the ship, was the belly of tea. The winds were up, a bell dipped down. Oh, blow, my bully boy, blow. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tugging is done, we'll take our leave and go. Thing for the fucking woman. Oh, gamers here. I'm gonna have to wait a bit, gamer, because the train fan is gone right now. Game, are you still there?
Await and south in the land of traitors, rattles, snakes, and alligators.
Hey.
Hey. I am a fadass.
Hey, guys.
What's your question? We already have a schedule for today, my friend.
No, I want to talk to you.
And Kyo, you already know what's coming up.
Because I've been trying to
No, I haven't talked to Tech.
Is gamer cutting out for me? Is it just me that gamer's cutting out for? Is gamer cutting out for me?
No.
Right.
You got it.
Okay. How to build shay.
Making my go shay, are you?
He's building his own shay that he worked on.
Right.
Okay. Guys,
can you please stop?
I do have to
get of course.
All right, bye, gamer.
Here she is.
Okay, just tell Ted if you talk to Ted.
Right.
Tell him I want to talk to
him. You'll ask for this. Okay. I need a tool. Be right back. I'm going to get me a tool. It's my tool over there. Nope. Welcome back. Okay, now that the thing is over, now that I finished my food, I'm going to show y'all how to build a simple shay. I'm going to be doing like what my friend Scott did. Hey y'all. Scott here. Right, there we go. Oh, we don't saw the land that treasures rattles next and alligators run away. Run away. Run away. Run away. Run away. Right.
The gamer leave.
Okay, this is my first ever tutorial and I'm not looking forward to
the gamer leave.
Yes, it is. Oh yeah, let me just
also it's okay if you can stop sharing audio because I can
kind of invite the others.
Also if you can stop sharing audio because I can kind of be
yeah, sorry.
Thank you.
Simple. Yeah. For real. We don't live in the land of traitors, rattlesnakes, and wily gators. Oh, we don't live in the land of traitors, rattlesnakes, and alligators. Right away. And Union boys will win the battles right away. I'm out of breath. Okay. We'll all go down to Dixie. Away. It's Union boy will. I don't know what the Union boy is going to do. Oh, we don't solve the London traitors, rattlesnakes, and wacky laters. So, how are you today, Cube?
Tired.
Why? Okay, you ready to build the simple shape?
I'll probably have to build it once the stream is done because I'm working on a flat car right now, but I will build it. I want to build at least.
Right,
at least the engine.
Right, my internet seems to have a lot of issues right now. So my internet would seem to have a lot of issues. Who would have thought? Right, anyways. Okay, so for the first part, you're going to build the chassis. So the materials that you, the blocks that you're going, the bricks, well, the parts that you're going to need. It's a good question. I don't know. Yay, willy nilly. Let's begin with, of course. Okay, right. So for the shape front, the chassis, you're going to need this type of brake. So you're going to need like this. You're going to need. It would seem to be. A 12x4 underneath here, that's a 12x4, a 2x6, so for the bottom layer, sorry, you're going to need one 12x4, black. If you want to do another color, go ahead. And you're going to need two 4x6 ones, and two 2x6, and a 1x2 plate right there. For the top, I just knocked off the boiler. You're going to need a 2x3, a 4x12, two of those, a 2x10, right there, right here, and a 1x6. We're going to put them like it appears here. That's the bottom part. That's the back part. Now that you have the chance to build, I'm going for the next part. The wheels, the easiest part, of course. We're going to need, I don't know if Cube has them, which is why I'm doing this and other friends as well. You're going to need two of these parts, turntable parts. You're going to need two. Doesn't matter what color, I just had these two colors in hand. But for the first first truck, is going to be the simpler one. You're just going to need two 2x6 plates. If you have any others, go ahead, as long as it works. And then you're going, and the wheels are going to be all together like this, and the turntable in the middle. That's for the first truck. And the second truck, let me dismantle it a bit, because it's easily repairable. So for the second truck, you're going to need a 2x4, a 2x2 with a knob on the front, like that, and a rotating part, and two wheels. So you just put them on, and there you go. Those are the trucks. Cube, if you need, okay, you're muted, okay then.
I'm just being quiet while you're doing the tutorial.
Okay, so here's where we start constructing. So first, you're going to need two 1x6 plates, pieces. You're going to need two bricks like this in black, and you're going to put them in the gap that's in front. As you can, sorry. There we go. So in here, there's a space that you're going to put the pieces on, and then you have the front. It doesn't have that much realism. I could have added realism, but if you want to, go ahead. This is the cool part about this shape build. You can modify it however you want. And then we go to the trucks. For the back truck, if you're building a one truck shay, you're of course going to need, instead of having the bolt joint there, you could have a magnet or any other form that you use to couple your rolling stock. So first, you're going to put it in the middle where it looks like this. There's one one line of studs revealed, and the rest of them are like, then yeah. And the second one, if I can even find where I put it, there it is. And the second one, you're going to have as well one space in front, and this is going to give it enough clearance to swing from side to side to be able to go around curves. Because in my scale, normal R40 curves, I prefer to use those as logging tracks. And then to continue building the chassis, you're going to need a 2x8, an 8x2 plate. Put two of these plates that have the holes that are ramps. That is going to give the effect of the gearing and stuff like that. And then you're going to need a 2x4 ramp slope with the studs showing in the top. And you're going to put it like, you're going to make it like this. You're going to have these two parts, and you're going to leave one stud in between. Like, well, not a stud. You're going to leave one stud empty. Put the two parts like this, and then put the sloped part here. And to make it more smooth, you're going to add the 1x2 plate that's here. And then once you're going to install it, you're going to put it. You're going to grab the four the studs here, and you're going to put them in the second line. Don't put it on the first one, because in the first one, it's going to look too bulky, as you can see here. I'm going to put it one stud behind of the beginning, so it will look, it's going to stay flushing within six studs wide, and you're going to make it facing backwards. So it gives the effect that there's like some detail here, even though there's not. Then, I'm not skipping the important things yet. I'm going to get into that. I just want to do the simpler things, so your shay starts looking like a shay, because complicated parts are the cab and the boiler. But right now we're just going to continue this. Then we're going to build the bunker. that's behind of the shay. By the way, the one that I modeled is, oh, sorry, it's Western Maryland number 5, and I added a diamond. Oh, I added a diamond stack because I couldn't find another one of these. If you have 2 of these, you can make it look like actual Western Maryland number 5. But anyways, for the bunker behind the cab, it's going to end up looking something like this. Of course, there's going to be doors. But basically, what you're going to do is that you're going to do 3 of these parts, which is a 2x4, it's a 1x4 brick, 1x in color black, 1x4 stud in yellow, another 1x4, in here I had to accommodate with 2x1, 1x2s, but doesn't matter. I'm just going to say it as a 1x4 black, another 1x4 plate. I dropped the thing and it went to my desk. Hold on. Sorry for the inconvenience.
Oh dear.
Oh shit. Oh fuck. Gotta keep me. Oh shit. I dropped it and now it's impossible to grab with what I was having, so I'm going to get a hook. Give me a hook. Thank you. I'm going to modify it so I can pull out and hook. It's missing several. God damn it. Oh dear. Sorry about this.
I am so sorry again. You can see that things it's back there. It doesn't seem much more.
Good ending. Good sentence. Okay. Sorry about that, everybody. Oh, dear. Okay. Back to the tutorial. So you're going to, of course, need to build 3 of these, of the exact same parts. And once you do that, you're going to put them aside. Oh, and you're... Okay, let me do it again. Okay, hold on. Anyway, you're going to need a 1x4 brick, 1x4 plate, yellow, 1x4 brick, of course, all of the bricks are black, 1x4 plate again in yellow, a 1x4 in black again, and a 1x4 plate but black. Once you do that, you're going to make 3 of those, and it should look like this. Once you do that, you're going to do the top of the part. If you have a 4x6 plate, you can use that, but I used a 4x4 and a 2x4 to make the 4x6. And then you're going to add some tiles. In this case, I used a 1x6. Oh, hold on. Again, I'm sorry for the inconvenience. Anyways, let me recap. Oh my fuck. Sorry. You're going to need a 4x6 black plate, two 1x3 tiles, and a 1x6 tile on here. So it would look like this. If you have, like, if you did what I did here, it's going to be better. But if you want to make it look better, if you have the 2x6, I mean 4x6, it's having one by four tiles alongside everywhere. Once you do that, you're going to just build them in the box shape of your desire. My arm hurts. And then we go. Here's the back the bunker, if you may call it that. And then you're going to put it right at the back. And there we go. Back. Now, we're going to install the windows. You're going to need two of these. They're 2x2s with a stud in the middle. And you're going to put them right next to, right in front of the bunker, aka like this. And then you're going to do the windows, which are way simpler. And this is going to where it's going to get complicated. You're going to need three 2x1x2s bricks, plus a 1x2 clear part, plus I recommend like this, aka a 2x2 tile on top, and it will look like this. If you have those types of bricks with those ones, like what I did here, perfectly fine. You don't have to change it, or like this, as long as it looks smooth on the top, which is like that. Once you do that, you're going to put them in the cab area, and it should look like this. Those are your doors. Oh my god, be right back. Again, I am so sorry for the inconvenience. back to the tutorial. Okay. Now that you have partially of the cap done, you're then going to go back to underneath. And here is where the details come in play. Let me just do a test real quick. Okay. What you're going to do is that you need two of these. If you can, just two of the 1x2 upside down slopes, but I had to use these ones because I couldn't find any. You need two of these. And the first one, you're going to put it at the beginning of the second plate, aka right behind one stud, well, one stud apart from the back truck. Of course, it's going to give it the ability of spin because it's a slope part. And then you're going to need a 1x6 brick. You're going to put it right behind. And lastly, another one, of course, the second one, and you're going to put it right along step. And it's not going to disturb anything on the truck. And there we go. You officially have a chassis built with a partially of a cap. And now we're going to the fun part. We're going to start construction on the cylinder part. First, this is going to be complicated, so I'll go slower. So here's what you're going to do. Let me separate it by sections. First section is where the steam cylinder and the brake injectors, if you may call them that, are. It's a step system. So you're going to need a 1x2, a 2x4, another 1x2, a 2x3, and two more 1x2s. And it should look like this. Once you have that built, you're going to put it on the side. And then this is going to be simpler. You're going to need one of these. If you don't have any, I'm sorry, but it's important. And then you're going to put it right there where these two holes are. You're going to put it right there. Hold on. I know these don't look like Legos, and that's true because they are not Lego. They're just Mega blocks, I think. And you're going to do something like this. It should look like that. And then you're going to make this. You're going to need two 1x1 round pieces, a 1x2, and two 1x1 cylinders. You're going to make it look like this. And then you're just going to put it right there. And there you go. You'll have the first section of the running board. Next up is where the fun begins, if you may call it fun. I mean, it is Lego. You're going to need four by four cylinders, and you're going to need, let me see how long this is. You're going to need three axles of the length of three studs, aka these ones. If you don't have any like this, I am sorry, they are important. Then you're going to build something like, you're going to make three cylinders. They're basically simple and genius because I made those. Let me just align the one that it took off. I'm going to make something like this. It has to look like that. And once you have that built, you're going to put them aside. You're going to need three, of course. Here they are. And then you're going to the running board, which is a 2x8, an 8x2 plate with a 4x4, a 2x2 plate of the color yellow, a yellow color plate. And then you're going to need, listen carefully, you're going to need two 1x2s in black, like this. Let me get it up close. And then you're going to need a one by two yellow plate and a 1x2 brick. And it should look like this. And then you're going to install the cylinders, and it should end up looking like this. Once you have that built, you're going to grab again this part, and you're going to put it again, and it should look like that. This is your cylinders. This is the cylinders of the shay, and once you have that built, you're going to grab the shay, the what you have built, and you're going to put it like this. It should cover the space that you left between the wheels. It should look like that. Once you have that built, congratulations. This is where it gets hard. First, well, it's not that difficult. This part is the cab. I'm going to split it into three sections again. And here's what... Oh. First, you're going to need a 1x4 in black, a 1x4 brake in black, a 1x4 plate in yellow, 1x4 brake in black, and a 1x4 plate in yellow, and that's the lining. Then you're going to need two of these 2x2 windows. You're going to need four of these. You're in the first section, you're going to need two. And then you're going to add a one by one brake and a 1x1 brake with a stud on the side. Once you have done that, you're going to need exactly this, like it's like the minifigure hand. And then you're going to put a six studs long rod. It should be like this one. It doesn't matter the color of these two, preferably black or gray. I used white because I don't have any other colors. And you're going to put it like so. And you have one of the cab walls. Once you have the cab built, you're going to put it. Let me just be aware that it has to be aligned. You're going to put it right here. So if I curse a lot, it's just acting up. And it should look like that. Very beautiful. It's beautiful and it looks smooth. And then you're going to do the second layer. You're going to need a 1x6. In black, a 1x6 bricks, a 1x6 plate in yellow, 1x6 brick in black again. Hold on, I need to get some. So I need my pointer thing again. I forgot about it. Let me go over it again. 1x6 brick, 1x6 plate in yellow, 1x6 brick, 1x6 in yellow again. And again, it's the same layout as the windows. But be careful, it has to look like that. And if you put it on the model, it should look like this. There should be this part has to be facing the front as well on the other, if you didn't know. And of course, for the window section is the same as the other one. Just need another one of these, put it there. And congratulations, you have handrails on your shay. And then you put it back on. And there we go. You officially have two walls of a shay. And now we go to the cab roof. We're going to need four 2x4 curb slopes, like those ones. I'm going to show you how to build this. Because it can get complicated. Right, so. You're going to need a 4x8 plate, and then you're going to add a 2x4 there, and it should look like this. Pretty normal, self-explanatory. And you're going to grab these pieces, which are the 2x4 slopes, The first one, you're going to give it a space of one. It should be extruding or for one stud. Leave a gap in the middle and put the other one like that. Then you're going to grab a 1x6 and you're going to put it in the space that you left behind like that. And then you're going to grab another one of these, another one, and then you're going to grab a 2x8, put it in the front of the 1x6, and it should look like this exactly. And once you do that, you should have a space. It should be looking like that. You're going to add the other one, and it looks like this. Then this is where it gets fun. You're going to need 2 1x2 curved slopes, those pieces. And you're going to need a 2x4, a 1x4 plate. And you're going to make it something like that. You're going to put it in the space that you left behind. And it should look like that. And now you're going to need a 1x4 and put a tile on top, a 1x2 tile, and then a 1x2x4 tile on the top. And you would have this with a space on the front, and then you're going to put it there. And then you just need to get a 1x2 plate and put it on top, and you have the roof. Then you're going to grab two of these 1x6 bricks, and you're going to put them on the top of here. This is how it looks. And then you're going to put it on top of the cap. It's going to be a bit of a struggle, but it's normal. It's Lego. And there you go. You have a shay cap built. Pretty simple, pretty self-explanatory. Enclosed cap, if you may. And then now we go to the difficult section, the actual difficult. You're going to make a cab, the boiler. May I say that this boiler design is based upon a design that Cube here, say hi Cube if you're there. And him, he designed this type of boiler, which I abruptly ripped off and made for my own. Oh dear, I dropped the bell. Right, okay, now it's time to do the boiler, the freaking boiler. You're going to need to make this. It's simple. It's just you need a 2x12 in dark bluish gray. You need two, and you make the first layer. Of course, you can always do what I did, which is a 6x6 or a 2x6 and then a 2x8 plus a 4x4 and it should look like that. And then you're going to get three bricks, 2x4 bricks, and then you're going to do the same as you did here. Or just, again, you can just have a 2x6 or whatever. Just as long as it's it should be two bricks tall plus two studs. Two plates, I mean. And it should look like that. And then you're going to add, if you want, I prefer you using only like dark gray parts because they can you can see the color of them. But if you have any other color, it's fine. You're going to need four of these 1x2 bricks, bricks with studs on the side. You're going to have them on the front and on the back. And there you go. That's the first part of the cab, of the boiler, and then you're going to start putting details. Okay, this is actually more difficult than I thought. I'm sorry. But anyways, you're going to need a 1x2 brick with a 1x2 tile on the top. It should be like that. You're going to put it all the way out back, like that. And then you're going to make a little thing here. You need specifically that brick because it looks like a bell with a white stud underneath. And you have the bell type. It should look like that. And it's going to be on top of a 1x2 brick, plate with studs in the middle. And you're going to need a 2x3. You're going to then go on top, and you're going to, in the 2x3, you're going to add the thing here, the bell, and then a 1x4 curb slope, like all the way. And it should look like that. Dome, which is just a cylinder, a 2x2 cylinder with a 2x2 dome with a stud in the middle. And oops. And you're going to need another one of these, but in the back. And there you go. You have the first part of the boiler. And then you're going to make another dome. It doesn't matter what type of brick. I use those ones because I don't have any other. You put it in front of the bell. It should look like that. And then you put a 1x2 tile in front of that dome. Make the funnel. You can use different types of funnel. You decide how it looks. Made a diamond stack like that. And finally, you add the lamp, which is just a 1x2 brick with a stud in the side with a yellow round tile under the front with a 2 1x2 tile with a stud in the middle. And there you go. You have the beginnings of the boiler. Now, here we go. Here's the difficult part. Okay, we're almost done. Don't worry. Then you're going to do the boiler. You're going to need a 2x12, a 2x8, and a 2x4. You're going to put them like that. And then for the top, it has to look like this. If you round it, it should look like, nope, it should look like this. And then for the front, you're just going to have a 1x6 that goes through the top part and a 1x4, I mean. So it's a 1x6 and a 1x4. In the top, it should be longer. You decide which one is the top. I prefer you choosing this one because it gives the effect that it's perfect, you know, that it looks nice. And it should look like this. And then you're going to need 2 1x8 tiles. Should look like that. And then on the top of the 1x2 tiles, you're going to need a 1x6 tile on the top and 3 1x2 cheese loops. So like that. And there you go. You have the first side. You're going to put it on the boiler. And ta-da. You have one side of the boiler. The second side is way simpler. Same layer again, but if you place it like this, the gray should be on the front, like that. It should be facing towards you if you grab it like this. And then just in the center of it, like, you're going to need, of course, two of these, 1x6. I mean, 2x12, sorry. You're going to need 2x12s. You're going to need two. One is going to be for the bottom layer and the top to connect everything. You're going to put it in between of these two, so right here in the center. And then you're just going to fill it in with any type of bricks that you have, any slopes. If you don't have any, then it's not difficult to find out. You can just put a 2x6 along this way and leave it empty here and add a 2x2 in the back. So you can do what I did. And once you place it, It should look like this. And now you have the boiler of a shay. Keep in mind, the reason why you have to do this is so that when you put the boiler in the shay, it shouldn't go cold side on this brick on the running board. And well, once you do that, you can just put it in, smash it, and there you go. You have built a shay. By the way, if you're going to build this and you're going to upload it in YouTube, please give me credit. This took too long to design and everything, but we're not done. It's time to do the simple run. If you want to give it more realism, you can do the tender, the second truck, the third truck. I'm going to make something like this. It's just the first part is two by sixes. They're going to be like this. And then you're just going to put them on top. There you go. And then for the bottom part, you're going to need the ball joint thingy that you're going to put here. And there you go. And then you're going to put the wheels. The first wheel is going to be right there. Second wheel, you're going to give it a space of one stud. It should look like that. There you go. And you're going to need two 6x8 plates and a 4x8 plate. It should look. Hold on, give me a second. Let me dismantle it so you can see it better. It should look like that. Put it on the top. Please keep in mind that you have to leave the space in the front like that. I started where you can see the metal thingy there. And there you go. And now you go to the trucks. You need a lot of parts. Who would have thought? Let me just dismantle it so I can build it. Oh, cut. I forgot to take off the bell. I mean the lamp. I'm going to build it here because it's not even that difficult. It's just a box. Hold on. There we go. So this is what you're going to have to do. You're going to make two of these, which is a 1x6 stud, yellow, a 1x4 and a 1x4 stud in the top. Should look like that. You're going to make two of those. And then you're going to make the side part, which is a 1x6 stud. Yellow, a 1x8, 1x8 stud on the top, and it should look like that. It's not that complicated, as I said. And you're just going to replicate that twice, and once you do that, you're going to put them like this. And there you go. You have built thing, the fangled doohickey. Once you have done that, you're going to make the second layer. And you're going to need, again, 6x8 plates. And if you don't have any, you can just do what I did, which is just. But yeah, it should look like that. And you have that built. You just put it on the top. And there you go. And now you're going to add the lining on it. Well, not the lining, the thing that hides it. And it should look like that. Doesn't matter how you do it. They did it like this. You can do it however you want. And you're going to add the light, which you put it right behind this one. And you add a 1x2 tile on the center piece, like that. You make the lamp however you want to. You can make it like the front lamp here, or you could make a new design. And then you just put it there, and there you go. There's a tender. You put it on the top of your chassis. And it should look like this. You couple it to your shay, and there you go. Western Maryland number 5, all built out of Legos, and you didn't have to worry about building the intensity of the gears. And that's how you build Western Maryland number 5. Thanks for watching.
Wow.
So yeah, that's all. And quick quick peek. Hold on. Quick sneak peek.
Wow.
Anyways, what do you think? That's the chain.
That's pretty sexy.
That took too long to decide. Thank you. And then, yeah, there you have the chain. And now it's time to how to build the Niagara. No, just kidding. No, just kidding. Anyways, thank you everyone for watching. I hope to see you later. Bye. And if I see enough people saying that it's not a good not a good showcase, or a model review, I'll do a tutorial once if people don't like it. If it's good like it is, perfect. Anyways, thank you for watching. Goodbye.